Good afternoon, students. I am Mayank Tiwari. Today we will solve test number 30 of the General Agriculture series. Let's start. Student, first question is, crop grow is a. You have to tell this crop grow is a remote sensing model in which of the following crop it is used. Option A, soybean model. Option B, cleft model. Option C, both. Option D, none. So student, this question is very important. This question is from precision farming. Precision farming, I told you, it is also called site-specific farming, GPS-based farming, and variable rate technology. This crop grow model is a soybean model, you remember it, and this is a remote sensing based model, so it is important. And this B option you see, cleft model. Cleft model is used in rice crop. In irrigated rice nutrient management, cleft model is used, please remember it. Student, question number 2 you see, oxalate is an important anti-nutritional factor found in. Option A, soybean. Option B, wheat. Option C, kidney bean. Option D, rice. Student, these anti-nutritional factors are very important. You have to remember all the anti-nutritional factors. So student, here they are. Polyphenol and phytic acid. They are the anti-nutritional factor taken found in wheat, maize and sorghum. Trypsin inhibitor, tannic acid, phytic acid and oxalate. These are the anti-nutritional factors present in kidney bean, lima bean, pigeon pea, etc. And this student, which I asked, oxalate is an important anti-nutritional factor. It is found as calcium oxalate in soybean. So students, remember it is very important. So if it is given like that, oxalate is found as calcium oxalate as anti-nutritional factor, you have to take soybean. And if it is given like oxalate only, then you can take any of the beans. And for wheat and maize, please remember students, polyphenol and phytic acid. And student, one important line is there, please remember it also. Blanching of groundnut and maize in boiled water reduces the retention of thymine, riboflavin and niacin. Please students, remember it. I am again repeating. Blanching of groundnut and maize in boiled water reduces the retention of thymine, riboflavin and niacin. Please remember it. Student, next question you see. Question number 3. Optimum time of harvesting for hay making in soybean. Option A, pod half stage. Option B, first pod maturity. Option C, soft pod to medium duff stage. Option D, early bloom to full bloom. So students, this question is important. You have to tell which of the following is the optimum time for hay making. Hay, fodder, silage, all of you must have heard. So student, here it is. For grasses, clove and lucerne, the time of harvesting is early bloom to full bloom for hay. And for cereals, if you are making hay from cereals, you have to harvest them at soft duff to medium duff stage. And in soybean, pod half and this cowpea, if you are harvesting for hay making, you have to remember at first pod maturity it is harvested. Please remember these, students, this is very important. Any student, if it is asked in general what is the optimum time for hay making, 50% flowering, 50% flowering harvest is the most optimum time for hay making, please remember it. Student, question number 4 you see, Srojan system has been developed in. Srojan is a student, it is like zero tillage system. So you have to tell in which country this Srojan system has developed. Option A, Indonesia. Option B, America. Option C, Molish. Option D, Trifolium patens. So student, option C and option D, these are nonsense option. Molish, you will be knowing, Molish coined the term allelopathy. Trifolium patens is red clover. So now option A and option B you eliminate. Srojan system has been developed in. So student, Srojan system has been developed in Indonesia. What is this Srojan system? This student, you see, Srojan system has been developed to overcome the problem. In this system, upland and lowland crops are grown in alternate strips. Rice is grown in flooded strips and your bean, mung bean, sorghum, cassava, cowpea and sweet potato are grown in the upland strip. Please remember, Srojan system has been developed in Indonesia, and in this system, alternate strips of upland and lowland crop are grown. This rice has been grown in flooded strips and your mung bean, sorghum, cassava, cowpea, they are grown in upland strips. Please remember it. Student, question number 5. This is damn easy for you. Which of the following is a broad leaf weed? Option A, Eclipta alba. Option B, Cypress rotundus. Option C, Echinocula colonum. Option D, Eleusine indica. Student, these four weed, you might have seen also. This Cypress rotundus, it is very common weed. It is a narrow leaf weed. You have seen, it is called motha. This Echinocloa colonum, if you have done PCP or have planted rice, you could have seen it. This is called Jangli dhan. and this Eleusine indica, you might have seen it, and this Eclipta alba is a broadleaf weed, please remember it. Eclipta alba is also called Bhrangraj, please remember it. So students, this classification of weed, you remember, some weed are grasses, this means they are narrow-leaved, Echinocula colonum, Digitaria sanguinalis, it is called crabgrass, it is also a narrow leaf, and Panicum repens, this is called Torpedo, Coloris barbata, it is called finger grass, Tragus biflorus, Eleusine indica, this is called goose grass, and Cynodon dactylon, these are all your grassy weed. Second is your sedges, Cypress rotundus and your Cypress reformis, these are sedges. And broadleaf weed, you remember, Celosia argentia, common Clombs viscosa, Portulaca aurelaceae, these are also broadleaf weed, Eclipta alba, Bhrangraj, I told you, Digera arvensis, Lucas aspera, these are all broadleaf weed. Please students remember them. Student, this question you see, which of the following weed causes sleeping sickness, African sleeping sickness? Option A, brushweed. Option B, Utrica. Option B, Ambrosia. Option D, Salvinia. So student, these are very important, the diseases caused by weed, so remember them. So students, please remember it. Hay fever and asthma, it is called by pollen of Ambrosia and Freycinetia. This dermatitis, skin allergy, it is called by Parthenium histolophorus and Ambrosia. Utrica causes itching and inflammation, please remember it. African sleeping sickness, it is called by brushweed. So brushweed is the correct answer. And student, please remember, aquatic weed like Pistia lanceolata, Salvinia auriculata, they cause malaria, encephalitis and filaria. These are caused by mosquitoes. So students, this table is important, please remember it. Student, question number 7, you see, water use efficiency of C3 plant. Option A, 2 to 3 gram of dry matter per kg water. Option B, 3 to 5 gram of dry matter per kg water. Option C, 20 gram of dry matter per kg water. So students, please remember it, the water use efficiency of C3 plant is 2 to 3 gram. This water use efficiency of C4 plant is 3 to 5 gram of dry matter. And this 20 gram is the water use efficiency of pineapple plant. Pineapple plant is CAM plant. Please remember it. Student, question number 8. In normal waters, concentration of boron is? Option A, less than 3 ppm. Option B, 3 to 4. Option C, 4 to 5. Option D, 5 to 10. So students, see this table. This is very important. In normal water, the concentration of boron should be less than 3 ppm. In low boron water, 3 to 4. Medium boron water, 4 to 5. High boron water, greater than 10, and if it is given boron water, B4, it is written 5 to 10. Please students remember it. Any student, please remember these EC values also. In normal water, the EC value should be less than 1.5. In low salinity water, 1.5 to 3. In medium salinity water, 3 to 5. In high saline water, 5 to 10. And in highly saline water, it is greater than 10. Please students remember it. Student, question number 9 is very important. Acid equivalent of ammonium sulfate is? Student, this acid equivalent is often asked. You have to remember it for all fertilizers. Option A, 110. Option B, 128. Option C, 86. Option D, 80. So students, please remember it. Ammonium chloride has an acid equivalent of 128. Ammonium sulfate has an acid equivalent of 110. Ammonium sulfate nitrate has an acid equivalent of 93. Ammonium phosphate has an acid equivalent of 86. And this urea has an acid equivalent of 80. Please students remember it. And also remember the equivalent basicity. Sodium nitrate has an equivalent basicity of 29, calcium nitrate has an equivalent basicity of 21, calcium cyanide has an equivalent basicity of 63, it is the highest, and dicalcium phosphate it is 25. So students remember it, these fertilizers you should know, acid equivalent and their equivalent basicity. And students, you also remember nitrate of soda potash, it is 26, equivalent basicity of nitrate of soda potash, it is 26, please remember them. Students, question number 10, you see, infiltration rate in subsoiling. Option A, 0.3 cm per hour. Option B, 1.45 cm per hour. Option C, both. Option D, none. So students, it cannot be both. It cannot be none. So the correct answer is 1.45 cm per hour is the infiltration rate in subsoiling. This 0.3 cm per hour is the infiltration rate in conventional tillage. So students, please remember it. That's all for today. At the end, please calculate your score and evaluate your score. If you have any complaint with regard to this video, please message me, and in case you find it helpful, please share it with fellow juniors and batchmates. Thank you.